Hey everyone, my name is Lyndon, and in this video I'm going to show you how to create a text reveal using Illumimat based on some stock footage I found on YouTube. So to get started here, let's make a new composition using Full HD, 30 FPS, 300 frames. I'm going to import my stock footage from YouTube, and let's take a quick look at this. So in this video, we've got some ink that's coming down. And because this video is black and white, it's going to be really easy for us to use this as a Illumimat. And another thing I'd like to note really fast is this video is at 60 FPS and the composition we're using is at 30 FPS. So as long as your composition is at 30 and you're using footage that's at 60, you're not really going to notice any quality loss. I mean, yes, the video will only appear to be playing at 30 because it is actually only playing at 30, but you won't notice any dropped frames. Every other frame is being dropped, but it's consistent. If you were to do it the other way around and your composition was at 60 FPS and you're using footage that's at 30, every frame would be held. Every other frame would be held. So you'd go a frame and then it would hold that last frame in order to fulfill that 60 FPS goal. So I'm fine in this case here, and I can even speed this up if I need to. Okay, so I'm going to drag this down and then I'm going to scale this up. Click the S key and then just type in 150%. And then I'm going to move this forward on the timeline. We can begin to see the ink coming down, and then I'm just going to recenter this. So at the beginning, I'm going to have it start maybe right there, and then we'll go further down. Now, this is going a little bit too slowly for me, so I'm actually going to speed this up. I'm going to go layer, time stretch, and I'm going to do a stretch factor of 50. This is going to play twice as quickly, but you're not really going to notice any loss because every frame here, if I step forward using the page down key, you're not going to notice any held frames. Okay, so now let's create our text. Pull that back up. So I'm going to do Control T to bring up the text tool. And I'm going to type in ink. All right, so I'm going to center this using Control Alt Home to center the anchor point, and then Control Home to center the text. Then just Shift Arrow up a couple times to get that heading towards the center. We also probably need to increase the size of ink just a little bit. So make that a bit bigger, and then I'm going to need to recenter that again. There we go. Okay, so we can now use this right away as a Illumimat, but first I'm going to change the color of this just so it's readable. Now I'm going to change this to white, and then I'm going to come down here to source name, right click, go to columns, switches. I like to have my switches and modes on the same line instead of having the toggle switches button. Okay, so to use this as a mat, I'm going to duplicate it, Control D, and I'm going to move it to the top. And this one I'm just going to rename to be Ink Mat. Okay, and then on this bottom one, we can just leave that. It's basically the background. Okay, all right, so with this is just what's going to show up. The mat is always going to be invisible, so we need to select the text, go to the track mat, and say Luma Inverted. Okay, so let's play this forward. And now you can see ink that's being revealed. The text ink is being revealed in the ink that flies by. And there is a slight problem. So if we go right to the very beginning and you zoom in, very hard to tell, but we can still see ink throughout this entire video. And that's because if we go to the select tool, go to the info in the upper right hand corner, and just mouse over this, you can see that this value is not true white. So it's a little bit underneath white, so it's still showing through a little bit. So in order to change that, we'll go into the ink mat. I'll turn this on to make it a little bit more obvious what we're doing. And I'm going to add a curves effect. Okay, so all we have to do is crush the white values very slightly. So crushing them, you can see I pull this forward a little bit. We're actually cutting into some of that black if you do it a lot. We only need to do it a little bit to get these values over here to be more than one, or just about one. It's going to be very hard. And since, yeah, you should never exceed one for visual information, but this is just a mat, so it doesn't really matter. We're never going to see it. I'm going to turn that off. And now we can see, if we play this forward, ink is being revealed. And then as the ink dies away, the text also begins to fade off. So that's the basic premise of what I wanted to accomplish here. However, we can go a little bit further and then add an effect to distort the ink based on this pattern. So to do that, what we're going to do, go into the ink text layer, and then we're going to look for an effect called displacement map. Okay, so I'm going to add the displacement map effect, and we're going to change the displacement map layer to ink mat. And we're going to say source effects and masks. And here you can leave these values in red and green. And you might say that, oh, there is no red and green. But remember, if you go into your info, there actually are RGB values here. They're just all the same. Okay, so we can actually increase this, making 10 and 10. And what you'll see is as the ink comes over the text, it does kind of make it wobble a little bit. And you can play around with the effects here to make it do something a little bit more interesting. And we can further expand upon this by adding an actual turbulent displace effect. Pull this over. And right away, you can see it's really, really distorting it. So what we want to do is probably reduce the size quite a bit and then reduce the amount quite a bit as well. Maybe you do a value of around 15 for the amount, and maybe for the size we can try something like 50, and then just scrub through and see if that looks like it's doing anything. And it doesn't appear to be doing all that much. Basically, we want this type of effect going on. But let's just add our expression and see how it looks. So in order to add an expression to evolution so we don't have to manually keyframe it, what we're going to do, hold down the Alt key and select the stopwatch for evolution. And the expression is time. And we're gonna say use the asterisk key for the multiplication. And you're gonna use how many degrees you want it to rotate per second. So I could say something like, I want it to go 90 degrees every second. And if we play this forward, you can see it's gradually wobbling. Maybe that's not enough, so we can increase that a little bit. Maybe just double that to 180. And then you can see it's flowing just a little bit more. So we get some interaction with the actual ink layer, but then we also have this subtle wobbling and something like that. Okay, so now we can see that for the majority of this video, the ink is pretty low down and we're not actually seeing a lot of the text. So I'm gonna select both the background and the ink mats. Just pull these up a little bit. Right. That's about as low as I can go on this, but that should be all right. Let's play this forward and see if that stays in frame for longer. And other things that you could do, you could use a time remapping to have this gradually slow down at this point, or you could further do as it is being revealed, it never disappears again. So you could use another mask. So there are a lot of other things that you could expand upon to make this into like an actually decent effect, but I just wanted to cover the basic technique of how you can use displacement maps and how you can also use just Luma mats based on some stock footage. So if you enjoyed this video, please subscribe, and hopefully I'll have some more videos out soon. So thanks for watching. Have a good day.